Assalamu alaikum, dear students. How are you? I hope you are well. I am also well by the grace of Almighty Allah. Today I am here to take a class on English first paper for class 9. So, dear students, get ready with your textbook, writing pad, and other necessary things. Let's start the class. At first, I would like to welcome you to my class. I am S.M. Munirujjaman, Assistant Teacher, English, Joshur Zela School, Joshur. Dear students, here is a picture for you. Look at the picture. Do you know her? Who is this lady? Dear students, try to guess who is this lady. This is Pritilata Wadedar. She was a great patriot. She was a dreamer. What did she dream? She dreamed of two things all through her life. She dreamed her society free from gender discrimination. That is, there would be no disparity between male and the female. Both the male and female will enjoy equal rights and responsibilities. And she had another dream. She wanted to see her motherland free from British colonial rule. So she was a dreamer. Like Pritilata, there were many dreamers in Bangladesh. Of them, Surya Sen, Zahir Rehan are worth mentioning. They also dreamed to set the country free. So dear students, our today's lesson is they had dreams. They had dreams, part one. So open your text at Unit 10, Lesson 3, Lesson Title, They Had Dreams, Part 1, Subject English Past Paper, Class 9. Dear students, now I would like to give you an idea about the text that we are going to read. The text deals with a famous dreamer, and the name of that dreamer is Pritilata Wadedar. Pritilata was born on 5 May 1911 in Chittagong. As a student, she was very much meritorious. She studied at Dr. Khastogir Government School in Chittagong, and then she studied in Eden College, Dhaka, and finally, she graduated in philosophy with distinction from Bethune College in Kolkata. From her college days, she became an activist of anti-British movement, and all through her life she dreamed of two things: a society free from gender discrimination and her motherland free from British colonial rule. She also took combat training to fight against the British rule. She returned Chittagong and she was appointed at the head teacher of Nandan Kanan Aparna School in Chittagong, and gradually she got herself involved in Surya Sen's armed resistance movement. Who was Surya Sen? Surya Sen was also a famous anti-British movement organizer and an activist in Chittagong area. In 1932, Surya Sen planned an attack on Pahartoli European Club, because the club was well known for a notorious sign at its entrance, "Dogs and Indians not allowed." Surya Sen assigned Pritilata to lead a team of 10 to 12 men to attack the club. Pritilata, dressed as a man, led the team and led the attack. Their attack was successful, but it's a matter of sorrow that Pritilata failed to come out. So she committed suicide by taking potassium cyanide. And by sacrificing her life, Pritilata proved that women can also work like men. And she also proved that women too needed to be prepared to sacrifice their lives for the freedom of motherland from British colonial rule. Her dream came true. That's our country became independent in 1947 from British colonial rule. But the irony of fate is that Pritilata couldn't see the emergence of her motherland in her lifetime. Okay, dear students, now I would like to introduce you to some new words, that is vocabularies. First on, activist. What is the meaning of the word activist? Activist means a person who campaigns to bring about political or social change. Its synonymous word is demonstrationist. Activist, Pritilata was an activist of anti-British movement. Second on, combat. What is the meaning of the word combat? Combat means fighting between armed forces. Fighting between armed forces. And its synonymous word is battle. Its synonymous word is battle. Pritilata took combat training to fight against British colonial rule. Third on, resistance. What is the meaning of the word resistance? Resistance means the refusal to accept or comply with something, and its synonymous word is defiance. Defiance. Pritilata gradually got herself involved in Shurjo Sen's armed resistance movement. Next, notorious. What is the meaning of the word notorious? Notorious means well known for some bad quality or deed. Well known for some bad quality or deed. Pahartoli European Club was notorious for a sign that was at the entrance of the club. The synonymous word of notorious is infamous. Its synonymous word is infamous. Next, sacrifice. What is the meaning of the word sacrifice? Sacrifice means to give up something valued for others. To give up something valued for others. Its synonymous word is dedicate. Pritilata sacrificed her most valued things, that is her life, for the sake of the country. Here is an activity for you, dear students. You have to make sentences using the words given in the box. In the box, there are 5 words. The words are activist, combat, resistance, notorious, sacrifice. You have to write 5 sentences using these 5 words. Dear students, use your own words to write down sentences. Try yourself at home. I think you will be able to write down sentences. Next, dear students, now I would like to read the text. You will follow me. Follow me very carefully and try to guess the meaning of the text. Pritilata was born in Chittagong on 5 May 1911. She was a meritorious student at Dr. Khastogir Government Girls School in Chittagong and Eden College, Dhaka. She finally graduated in philosophy with distinction from Bethune College in Kolkata. In her college days, Pritilata was an activist in the anti-British movement. All through her life, she dreamed of 2 things: a society without gender discrimination and her motherland without British colonial rule. She received combat training to fight against the British rule. Soon after, Pritilata became the head teacher of Nandankanan Aparna Charan School in Chittagong. Gradually, she involved herself in Shurjo Sen's armed resistance movement. Shurjo Sen was a famous anti-British movement organizer and activist in Chittagong area at that time. In 1932, Shurjo Sen planned an attack on the Pahartoli European Club. The club was well known for its notorious sign, "Dogs and Indians not allowed." Shurjo Sen assigned Pritilata to lead a team of 10 to 12 men to attack the club. The raid was successful, but Pritilata, dressed as man, failed to get out of the club. She committed suicide by taking potassium cyanide to avoid arrest. She proved that women can work like men. She also proved that women who needed to be prepared to sacrifice their lives for the freedom from the British colonial rule. Her dream came true. But the British rule came to an end, though she couldn't see it during her lifetime. Okay, dear students, here is a chart for you, and there are two parts here. In the left hand side, some words are given, and at the right hand side, the meaning of these words are given. Dear students, you have to match the words with their meaning. Try yourself, and at first, write down the words in your khata, and then match the answer, and write down the meaning of that word at the right side. Try yourself, dear students. Now match the answer. Graduated. What is the meaning of the word graduated? Graduated means took a university degree. Took a university degree. Activist. The meaning of the word activist is a member of a certain social or political group. A member of a certain social or political group. Movement. What is the meaning of the word movement? Movement means activities. Then gradually. Gradually means slowly. Assign. Assign means give responsibilities. Have you matched the answer, dear students? I think you have done it rightly. Next, here is another activity for you. You have to choose the correct answer from the following alternatives. There are 5 multiple choice questions here. You have to find out the correct answer. The first one, question number 1. Throughout her life, Pritilata had visions of dash. 2 things, 3 things, 4 things, 5 things. Here, 4 options are given. You have to find out the right option. Which one is the correct one? Which one is the correct answer? Dear students, write down the correct answer in your writing pad. And now, match the answer. Here, the correct answer is 2 things. That is option A. Throughout her life, Pritilata had visions of 2 things. Question number 2. The profession of Pritilata was dash business, teaching, service, military service. Okay, dear students, write down the correct answer and now match the answer here. The answer is option B, that is teaching. The profession of Pritilata was teaching. Next, question number 3. When did Surjosen plan to attack European club? When did he plan to attack the club? Dear students, write down the correct answer and now match the answer. Here, correct answer is option C, in 1932. Surjosen planned to lead an attack on Pahartoli European club in 1932. Question number 4. Pritilata took combat training with a view to dash, defending herself, welcoming the British rule, rejecting the British rule, struggling against the British rule. Why did Pritilata take combat training? Here, the correct answer is option D, struggling against the British rule. Pritilata received combat training to fight against British rule. Question number 5. potassium cyanide is a dash. What is potassium cyanide? Dear students, is it a poison, a medicine, a gas, a drink? What is the correct answer here? Write it in your writing pad and now match the answer. Here answer is a poison. Potassium cyanide is a poison. That is, here correct answer is option A. Okay, dear students, now you have to write answer of some questions. There are 5 questions here. You have to write down the answer of this question. The first one, why did Pritilata fight? Why did Pritilata fight? You know, in 1932, Pritilata attacked Pahartoli European Club in Chittagong. So, she fought in Chittagong area. Second question, when did she fight? She fought in 1932, during British rule. Question number 3, why did she fight? Why, for what did she fight? She fought to set her motherland free from British colonial rule. That is, she fought for the sake of the independence of her motherland. She wanted to see her motherland free from British colonial rule, and that's why she fought. Question number 4, what was Pritilata's profession? Pritilata was the head teacher of Nandankanan Aparna Charan School in Chittagong. So, teaching was the profession of Pritilata. Last question, what is your learning from Pritilata's life? What do you learn from Pritilata's life? We have got the lesson that we all, irrespective of male and female, should be ready to sacrifice our lives for the sake of the country, to fight against any enemies. Both the male and female should be ready. And this is the teaching, that this is the learning that we have got from Pritilata. Okay, dear students, here is a gap filling activity for you. There are 5 gaps here. You have to fill in the gaps with necessary information, and you can take help from the text that we have already read. Now, I am reading the text. Dear students, follow me carefully. Pritilata was an active dash of anti-British movement. She worked under the dash of Surjo Sen. She dashed the Pahartoli European Club and became successful, but dashed to come out. So she dashed herself to avoid arrest. Dear students, write down the answer in your writing pad. You have to write appropriate word. Now match the answer. Pritilata was an active worker. Pritilata was an active worker of anti-British movement. So the answer for gap number A is worker. Next, she worked under the dash of Surjo Sen, under the command of Surjo Sen, under the leadership of Surjo Sen. Here the right word is command. You may also use leadership. Next, she dashed Pahartoli European Club. What is the correct answer here in gap number C? She attacked the Pahartoli European Club. Here the right word is attacked. She attacked the Pahartoli European Club and became successful, but dashed to come out. Which one is correct answer here? Here the correct answer is failed, but failed to come out. She failed to come out. So she dashed herself to avoid arrest. Here the right word is killed. She killed herself to avoid arrest. Okay, dear students, now homework write down the homework. Your today's homework is you have to write the summary of the passage in Bay in your own words, and you have to write it in around 150 words. Okay, dear students, thank you for attending my class.